Oh, you know, I bet you're right.
Get excited. It's going to be so much fun. Oh, it's right. That's the back.
So guys, real quick, if you just need a little explanation to you, Ms. Kay is working on her librarian degree, and so she's going to be helping you guys a little bit too when we're working on the big research paper later this week. So she wanted to do a little lesson with you guys, a little introduction there, before we actually go to the library. So that's what this is. So I hope all eight of you really, really enjoy.
So, I know.
And she'll be filled because this is for part of her class, too. So.
Super excited. Everything for me is due on December 9th, so high five for me. Kind of like your research paper is due when?
Right before they leave.
So December 20th? 19th?
Yeah.
So mine's due, everything's due on the 9th, and yours is due 10 days later, so high five. So take about a minute or two, open it up, and then log on as guest, really, and then just open up an internet tab so you've got it there.
Yay! Thanks, everyone.
Excellent. It's going to be real corny, actually. Oh, no, I know Jacob.
That's it.
And I know Gavin.
Okay.
I've met you. I know you're... Just remind me of your name again.
That's right.
I wanted to say Ethan, but I thought that was your brother's name. It's not. There you are. All right, fantastic. Everybody ready to go?
Yeah.
Excellent. Remind me of your name again? RJ, you ready to go?
Yeah.
Okay, guys. Okay, so there's this thing called LibGuides. So if you are using a LibGuide, right, it's if you are if doing any of these things. Are you looking for reliable information? Are you completing a research paper? All of you would be like, yes, that's us. Right? Or if you're tired of just like typing crap into Google and then saying, well, I think this is it, right? We're going to use the LibGuides instead. It's much easier. It gets to your information a lot faster, and that way you know it's reliable. So, how do I get there? This is what you have to type in on that page you just opened up. It's tinyurl.com. So you can take your fingers, type it into the computer, tinyurl.com/ FC Tiger Library. So tinyurl.com/ FC Tiger Library. And it should take you right to the LibGuide page. I'll keep it up there for a second, walk around and make sure y'all got it. Oh, FC Tiger. Yep, FC Tiger Library.
Mm-hmm. Excellent.
FC, oh, not Tiger, it's just Tiger. Oh, tiny URL is one word. Tinyurl.com. Mm-hmm.
Everybody,
it should have a picture of Ms. Martin up there. So you type up here. You're actually going to type in that whole thing. These. This right here. tinyurl.com/ FC Tiger Library. And then a picture of Ms. Martin will pop up on the LibGuide page. Hey, look, you got there. How exciting. Jacob, you good? You got there? Sweet. Anybody else need assistance? All right, I'll leave it up there for a second more. That'll be so fun, guys.
I cannot see, dog.
I should have made it bigger, I didn't realize, but I'll know the next time.
Just your eyes.
Oh, RJ.
I done went to the wrong thing.
Yeah.
Let me see what you got.
Help me out.
I can help you out.
T-I-N.
Oh, yeah, tiny. Yep. tinyurl.com/ FC Tiger Library.
I still went to the wrong thing, right?
Oh, up here. You would type in. Ready, RJ? tinyurl.com. Hey, look at that!
Thanks.
Yeah, no problem. Oh, guys. So it should look like that. Cool. Okay, now you will get a little cheat sheet, a little how-to for this as well. You will see it in the class. But if you are here, do you see where the big black arrow is? Jacob! See where the black arrow is on my screen? Right, click there. What does that tab say when it says click here? Say it louder.
Research,
right, because you're doing research. So when you hit this tab, this is specifically for you, right? It'll look like this. Y'all there? You get research? Fantastic. Now, Kentucky Virtual Library has been having some hiccups today. So fingers crossed that it works, right? We'll see what we get. But if it doesn't work, you at least have a general idea of how to get there, right? So this is a really good starting point to say, I'm going to research X, Y, and Z. So I'm going to go here to start. Okay, this is going to give you a database versus just typing it into Google. If you access it from home, you'll have that type of screen. And on the piece of paper, I'll give you a username and password. But we're at school, which is really exciting. So I'm going to go to my computer and then see if we can get there. Okay. So we are here. Can you guys still see that on the screen? tinyurl.com/FCTigerLibrary. Ta-da! All right, now I'm here again, so what do I hit?
In research.
Research. Thank you, RJ. RJ, I like how you volunteer. That's the thing.
He's pretty
catchy. I know. And then my screen's a little squished in here, but we've got this. Now, for articles, it says right on the page for you. So Ms. Martin has tried to make this extremely streamlined for you. So if I'm looking for articles, just hit on Explora. If you put your arrow over it, it'll turn into that little hand. So go ahead and hit Explora, and fingers crossed, it'll work.
Ooh, hey.
Look at that. All right. Are you guys, I'll wait a second. Ethan's there. It should say for articles. You just hit that picture. Yep. As soon as you hover over that picture, you've got it going on. Yep, just hit the Explore button. Okay, now we're going to research something all together. That way you know what we're doing. Has anyone heard of Nefertiti? You have? No? Nefertiti? Anybody have any ideas about... It's a woman. Okay. She was a queen. Do you remember of what area of the world? You are absolutely correct. Nefertiti was a queen of Egypt, right? So we're going to type in her name. If you don't know how to type it, it's N-E-F-E-R, Nefer, right?
Who's in that game tomorrow, though?
Not me.
Who said it? We all did. Hey, girl.
Oh.
Okay. Nefertiti. So go ahead and type that in. That way we can look and see what comes up.
Okay. All right.
I'll leave it up there so that way you guys know how to spell it. And then I'm going to hit enter. So N-E-F-E-R-T-I-T-I, Nefertiti. Right? Nefertiti. But we're going to figure it out. Right? If you can tell, so she is a queen of Egypt. She has a lot of, well, there's a lot of artwork dedicated to her. She's kind of an interesting figure. Okay, everyone there? We know how to spell it. I'm going to hit go. Hey, look at that. Okay, is everybody here?
Yeah.
Okay, fantastic. Sure. Can you tell me how many articles came up?
A lot.
A lot. Do I need 737?
No.
No. Do I need an article from 1930?
No.
No. Right? If you're doing research, we need updated information. So if you can go to the, what side is left? Right? Left side of your screen, and I want to move this. This is just a sliding tool. What date do you think would be good?
2016.
Okay, so 2016 would be super updated information, right? Because that would just be last year. I'm sorry, remind me of your name again. Alexis, what'd you say? 2000 might be good. Think of, this is the scary part, guys. It's 2017, so 2000 was how many years ago?
17 years ago.
So if I'm looking for information, 17 years ago is kind of dated, but Nefertiti is a queen of Egypt, so it's quite literally ancient history. So 17 years ago might be okay, but I usually use, personally, I use a time span of 10 years. Ms. Stopson, do you have any preference on the span of years they use?
No, and that's something we'll talk about a little more later, too. It really, in some cases, does depend on what you're researching as well. Like, sometimes I get the example of, if you're researching the Titanic, like, there's nothing wrong with going back and looking at YouTube articles from that time period. Mm-hmm. But if you're looking for more updated, you have to researching current cures or current research on cancer cures.
Yeah.
Like, you don't want to use anything.
Yeah. Yeah. And we'll talk about that in a second, but I want to show you this right here. So if I do that, right, and then if we hit, oh gosh, I wish my thing was smaller. something else? Like, if you move the slider thing, is it just automatically updating for you, or is it my computer?
It's automatically.
Is it automatically doing it? Is it just me?
Oh man, that's a bummer.
Is everyone else's automatically updating? Then move it.
Okay. So when you automatically update it, what did it shrink the number to?
300.
Okay. So I'm sorry, my computer is not doing it. But when you move that slider along, right, we said we wanted updated information, and now we're only at a 10-year span, and so now we only have 300 articles to go through versus 737. Does that make a little more sense? Yeah? Sound good? Okay. All right. Do you have any questions about that Explorer thing?
Nah.
Okay. Do you want to look at an article to see if it's any good?
Yeah.
Okay, now here's the thing, because mine didn't update right away. So I'm going to take a peek at Gavin's real quick. I'm going to see what he's got, see if mine. So, ooh, good. So my top one is still the same, right? Who's buried in King Tut's tomb? So do you want to hit on that? That's a, how do I know what that is? The first one that should be on yours, who's buried in King Tut's tomb? What type is that? It should tell you. If you look right,
if you look right to the left. I told you it was terrible.
Okay.
Oh, I did? Alright, I'll get you there.
There's.
It's alright.
Hit research on the Explorer. Okay, so that first one where it says who's buried in King Tut's tomb?
It's a periodical.
What type? It's a periodical. Okay, where do you find periodicals?
Anybody?
Oh, no. Usually in newspapers. This one is in a junior scholastic, right? So if it was in what's a junior scholastic? You guys remember that magazine? Maybe? No? Okay, junior scholastic. The last time I read it, I think I was probably in sixth grade. So if it's a sixth grade type of periodical, magazine, article, whatever, what kind of information is going to be in there? If it's a sixth grade-ish level. So think about that. Right. I know y'all love to read. So if it's a sixth grade level, do you think the information is going to be difficult? Or that the reading level is going to be difficult? No, right? So you might actually get some good starting off points. Do you think that would be one that you'd want to put in your citation for a senior level research paper? No, right? But if you go to a biography, right, I don't know if this one's still there, but if you go to this biography, which is all about Nefertiti, that might be a little more reliable, a little more academic in a sense. Does that help a little bit? Okay, so I'm going to ask some questions. So, Jacob, do you remember the URL, like the website to go to get to the LibGuides to start?
tinyurl.com/FCTigerLibrary.
Okay, fantastic. And when you get to that main page of your LibGuide with a picture with Miss Martin on there, I know RJ already knows this. Oh goodness.
Well, I don't know anymore.
Gavin, what button do we, what tab do we hit from there?
Research.
Research. Okay, so now we're on the research page. Asia, if you're on the research page, did we get there?
Yeah.
Okay, so from here, what would I hit to find an article? Say louder. Explora, right? So that's how you get to your article database. Okay, who have one? Okay, now RJ, I don't want 1930 to 2017. Where do I go to shrink or to change the dates of my publication?
Scroll down.
Uh-huh.
Then you see publication date.
Yeah. And you just slide it back and forth, right? So, and again, and that's going to depend on what you are researching, right? Okay. I do want to show you something else. Now, what I want you to do is open up a new tab and just go to google.com. Because I know a lot of you will think, but why can't I just do Google? Well, that's a great question, right? Oh, gosh, what's happening? Where's my PowerPoint? Okay. Okay, and, uh-oh, guys. My little clicker. Okay. Everybody good? Did you open up a new one? Literally, just open up a new tab and hit google.com, right? Because I'm going to come back to this slide. I'm going to go and, yeah, there we are. Okay, So the Lib Guide, right, Miss Martin's page, that took you right to Explore, which gives you articles directly that you know you could use. You just have to decipher, like, is it one I want to use, or was it like a sixth grade reading level room? So what if you just typed in stuff for Google? How does that help you? Does it help you? Ethan says maybe so, kind of.
It could if you find something that's...
Yeah, it's possible, right? So here's what I want you to look for. So things like .com, .biz, etc. What are some other .com, .biz? Things that, I don't know, you see a lot of, right? But if it's .edu, .org, .gov, those three domain names are a little more reliable in their information. So here's a pop quiz, right? Openness. The one that I said, remind me of your name, the one that I like your water bottle. Remind me of your name?
Michaela.
If I, is Wikipedia.org a reliable website? Wikipedia.org. Well, you know Wikipedia, right? So Wikipedia.org. No. Why would you say no? Okay, so the .org is kind of confusing because generally speaking, .org is a little more reliable. Exactly right. So Wikipedia is not reliable because, as RJ said, anyone can edit it. However, there is a way you can focus in your search on Google. So if you're at your Google site, just type in Google Advanced Search, like in the actual search bar. And then we're going to go from there. Okay, so we're still going to stick with Nefertiti because I find her fascinating. However, when I typed her in on Google, just like checked her name in, how many hits did I get? A lot. Just like the LibGuides, am I going to go through 8,760,000? No, because some of that information is probably from Wikipedia, it's probably from somebody's blog that I really don't care about or can use in a research paper. So how do I focus it down? So if you typed in Google Advanced Search in Google, or if you just go here, right, it'll come up with a different screen. So do you have it? I don't have it as a snapshot, so do you have it on yours?
Uh-huh.
Okay, so just go to Google Advanced, right, I'll type in mine. I'm going to exit out of here, that way you can see it. So if you type in Google Advanced Search, you just want this first one. And I'm going to show you how to narrow down your choices. Right? Is everyone there? Gavin says yes. RJ, you here?
Yes.
Michaela, you here?
Mm-hmm.
Asia?
Mm-hmm.
Excellent. Gentleman over here? Jacob, you there? Mm-hmm. I can see your screen from here. Okay, here we are. I'm going to click this. I'm going to type in Nefertiti, because that's who we're searching for. Right? N-E-F-E-R-T-I-T-I. But let's say I'm really looking for academic things. I only want sources that are from .edu. So you would scroll down to here. Hold on, what happened? Oh, gosh. Where it says site or domain. And then you literally type in .edu.
Is it Netflix or
NERF? Never. N-E-F-E-R. Nefertiti. So type in Nefertiti. Right?
Like,
go to site or domain. I'll walk around and help you guys. Got it?
That was
tough. .edu, perfect. Once you have .edu, go ahead and hit search. And we'll see how many comes up. Because I can guarantee it's going to be a lot less than that 8 million we had.
Nefertiti.
Nefertiti.
She
Okay, I'm gonna hit advanced search. Okay.
What, guys? What's the name?
That's why. Guys, you guys, somebody put in .edu. I gotta follow my own directions. Alright. So, how many did I get there? I went from 8 million hits to how many? Yeah, 62,000. So it took it down a lot. And I know that every single article, piece of information is coming from a website that ends in .edu. It's from some educational organization. Is that a little more reliable than something that's from a .com? Mm-hmm. Right? You would hope that an educational organization would be more reliable. Okay. So, do you have questions, comments, concerns?
No.
Okay. Anything about Google Advance? It was just a brief interlude, right? Just a little intro. You feel good about it?
Feeling good?
Okay, so here's what I want you to do. I want to see if you can do this. Can you make your way back to the research page from our LibGuide without hitting just the backspace button? Right? So can you make your way back to that LibGuide? Okay, so here's the thing. You're all like, I've got so many sources and so many articles and all these websites and it is awesome. I've got all this information. Where do you put it? How are you going to show Ms. Dobson, yes, I got this information from a reliable source?
Screenshot.
Copy the link, screenshot it, but what else can you do? Has Ms. Dobson
cited?
Yay, citation. What type of form or what format do you use for you? Do they know that?
We talked about it, but I don't know if they realize there are others.
Ooh,
starts
okay.
With an N.
What format do you use for your citation or for your citing? Jacob, do you know?
What
format do you use for your citations? When you make your works reference form, Gavin, what do we think?
It's like MLA format.
It is MLA format. So this is what I want you to do. If you're here, and I'm being quite serious, that research page Ms. Martin made specifically for people who are doing research projects. So hit the citation one here. And I want to make your life extremely easy. So if you pay attention real carefully, the 8 of you will have such a heads up on the other kids. Okay, citation, right? And what does it say? That first thing says what?
Easy bit.
Go ahead.
Create your citations using the correct format.
Bam. There's a whole website that you can use, so you know you do it correctly. So if I hit easy bib, right? Ta-da! What, guys? My computer.
There we go.
Okay. I was so sad. All this advertising popped up. Okay. So RJ, you said I could screenshot it, I could give her the link, but if I have the link, right, where can I put it?
In there.
Do you know what it does?
It cites
it. It'll cite it correctly for you. So let's say, I don't want Harvard Gazette. Maybe I want this one, something from MSU. Who knows, right? So I go to this link. I'm going to use information from here in my research paper. So RJ, instead of just copying the link, right, I have to do that still. So I'm going to go up here, right? I'm going to copy it, and then I go back here, and then I just put it there. Then what do I do?
Hit cite it.
Let's see what happens. It'll say, is that the one you're talking about? Of course it is.
Yeah.
So here's what it does for you. It tells you what it found. What did it find? So Jacob, can you tell me what it found? Like, just list off the green check marks. What did it find? What did it find? Just read the green check mark. What did it find?
I know
what
it found.
That's great. Yep. Website title?
The article title.
Yep.
Electronically published.
Yep, the day it was published. The day it was accessed. So the only thing you might have to fill in is if you know the publisher and if you know the author. Right? And that might just come directly from the article or the website. Yes, you got a question? No? Okay. So then you hit continue to final step. Guys, I've used this so many times in my own research papers. It makes my life so much easier because I have to use APA formatting, which is different than MLA. And it's, well, formatting anything is a pain.
Hey, can I have one quick warning?
Yeah.
And guys, too, when you hit that cited, make sure that you double check the citation, because sometimes people who don't really know what they're doing save their citations, and that's how it ends up in there. So double check and make sure that it's not missing any information or anything.
So it'll pop up the last screen prior to this. It had, okay, review your information, and then you hit cite it, and then there you go. You just copy and paste it right into your Word document. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Again, big barrels of fire over here, guys. Woo! Monkeys in a barrel. Okay, any questions about that?